Every day, I wake up knowing that the more people I try to save, the more enemies I will make. And it's just a matter of time before I face those with more power than I can overcome.
I'm so sorry, I'm late.
I had a traffic thing.
Did your traffic jam have anything to do with being, I don't know, shot at by machine guns?
Yeah, yeah. Oh, that was implied. I was implying that.
Peter Parker. Harry Osborn.
You're gonna want to see this.
Oscorp.
Had you
under surveillance.
Why?
Isn't that the question of the day?
There's something you're not telling me yet, May.
I once told you that secrets have a cost. The truth does too.
My name is Richard Parker. I have discovered what Oscorp was going to use my research for. I have a responsibility to protect the world from what I know they're capable of.
What is all this?
The future.
We literally can change the world.
What about Peter?
Not everyone has a happy ending.
This is bigger than you, Peter.
I made a choice.
This is my path.
Soon, everyone in the city will know how it feels to live in a world.
Just funny. You want to have a meeting. You want to discuss business. So why in God's name, you know, what, as in, why should I come and meet you? Is it not that, okay, even if we think of somewhere neutral to have a meeting, you know what I'm saying? Maybe meet up somewhere in the middle or something. The guy said, so you come to my office, okay, and he was even dictating the day and dictating the time. Not even asking me, is Tuesday good for you? What about what time? He goes, no, you will come Tuesday at 2 o'clock. You hear me? And like Tuesday at 2 o'clock on the mainland. You must be joking. Whatever. Some learner stuff. I beg. Meanwhile, have you seen the video for this Drake's Started From The Bottom? The one that, you know, I know we have the song, we have it here, then we have the remix, but in the video is just for the original song, not for the remix. Wiz Khalifa was not, you know, kidding. But let's check it out anyway. Let me look for it and play it. Great, great stuff, stuff. Okay, listen to this. Yeah. Now, because of Draco, everybody would think they started from the bottom. You now see everybody quoting Drake all of a sudden.
Started from the bottom, now my whole team here. Started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now the whole team here. Started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now my whole team here. Started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now the whole team here. I done kept it real from the jump.
What the heck was that?
Started from the bottom, now we here.
Huh? Whatever has it. Jesus Christ! Jamie! Jamie! Leave me alone! Jamie! Jamie!
name is Tracy, and welcome to another episode of Reality Access. Do you listen to Beat FM during the weekdays between the hours of 5 to 9 p.m.? Well, my lovely viewers, I don't need to tell you who we have in our studios today. It's none other than the delectable Miss Bailey. You know, people think it's easy to develop personal style overnight, but that's hardly the truth. Plus, there's a misconception out there that only skinny girls can be truly fashionable. Today, we're going to prove you wrong and make you a believer. Curvy girls can, too, wear clothes off the runway. I am at the Ocean Bay Mall in the very fashionable interior design store called Homes and Fabrics to meet my personal stylist and designer, Miss Tenia Lasego of Clan, who is going to be consulting Bamy today. Now, Bamy has just been abducted from her radio station, and we're bringing her to Sari Signatures to give her a total makeover. Let's go. Sorry that I'm the reason that you're here. We did plan with people from Beat FM to have you here. But don't worry, it'll be fine. Your friends wouldn't want to kill you. All right, cool. So here's the deal. Okay. We're going to have Sari. This is Sari Signatures. This is his salon. And he's going to be transforming your hair. This is Essay of Epiphany Makeovers. She's going to be doing your makeup. And this is Tenia Lasego of Clan, who's going to be doing your wardrobe, okay? We're going to leave you now to start on your hair, and then we'll do your makeup, and then you come meet us downstairs to do your wardrobe. Don't ask any questions now. I'm sure you'll be happy with the results. Is that okay, baby?
Yeah, I have a choice.
You don't have a choice, I'm afraid. How did you feel being abducted from your own, from your workplace?
What do you think?
Don't worry. All right, so I'm going to leave you now for Sari to start his makeover. This is before, and I hope we'll see after. Sari, what are you going to do to her hair?
I'm going to give a nice, lovely volume to her hair. We're going to work it out with the stylist and the makeup artist. All of us are going to do a transformation.
Okay, cool. All right, so you guys have decided what looks. Well, I'm gonna be surprised myself, so.
Don't worry.
All righty.
Meet us.
All right, cool, bye. All right, so Tani, tell me, like, when you think about Bamy, what do you think her style is about?
Well, I think, you know, naturally, I think because, you know, she's not skinny completely. Mm-hmm. I think, she'll lean towards like more conservative,
you know, conservative clothes
stuff, and I kind of want to change that today.
All right, because you think, because my take on it is, Bamy is on radio. If you've heard her, she's very brave. She's very, you know, she's not afraid to voice her opinion. She's very cut to the chase.
Yeah.
She tells it like it is, and she believes that she's Nigerian. And she's proud and she's bold. So I would describe Bamy on the radio as this bold personality who isn't afraid to back down or say what is on her mind or isn't afraid to be heard. And but then when it comes to her personal style, I think she threads on the safe path, and she's very, I don't know if it's afraid or she just doesn't care about fashion.
Yeah, that's what I was saying about like being conservative.
Yeah.
Just because, but you know, you really don't have to. You can actually wear, there are so many things that you can wear.
So there are fashion pieces that...
There are fashion pieces that are bold,
mm-hmm,
and that are flattering,
mm-hmm,
and you know, that could really, really just, you know, transform her and make her look completely stunning.
Okay.
So I think, yeah, I'm really happy. Like, I think I'm excited.
Okay, I would say Veronica Vane Style is her stylist at the moment, and I have been seeing some improvements with her style. I mean, I don't think, you know, there's some people who aren't like fashionable, but there doesn't mean that you shouldn't have your own personal style, and your style has to exude, your style has to be kind of a part of your personality.
Yeah.
So I think we should give her some bold looks. What do you think?
I think so. I agree.
So what kind of looks do you think that we will be?
I want to kind of introduce two different things. I want to introduce a dress. It's kind of flirty, kind of fun, playful, rather than just, you know, those simple structured dresses that people go for because they think they're just, you know,
trendy.
Like, there are other things that you can wear that are more playful but still, you know, as nice. And we could also do I want to introduce the pantsuit.
I never see Bemi in pants, actually.
Yeah.
I've never really seen her in pants. All right, so let's look at some of her pictures. Let's see, like, two looks that we not so much like and two looks that we absolutely love and think that she should be threading towards. All right, ooh. So tell us about what you think about this look.
Well, I just think that it's very, you know, in a bid to just be safe, she's gone with a very simple dress, and it has really no kind of shape. Mm. So she's, because of that, tried to compensate by putting on a belt.
Mm-hmm.
But then this belt is too fat, and so it just draws attention to, you know,
her waist,
and then it's not giving her a defined waist.
Mm-hmm.
So
it's separating her body.
It's separating her body into two halves, which is not. That's not. You don't want to
the
do
look.
That.
Okay, let's see one of the looks that we actually love.
Wow! And you know what? I think blue is her color.
That really looks amazing. Her hair, her makeup looks fantastic. I definitely love that dress on her. And I know Veronica's style. This Veronica has been doing a good job with styling Bemi, but I think that with Veronica styling her. I love Veronica, she's amazing. I mean, I've had her featured in our style episode, but I think that this just says, I look beautiful, I look lovely. But I think that Bemi still needs to find her set style. You know, like when we see something that we see a dress on a rack, we'll be like, oh my God, that is so Bemi.
Okay.
But I don't think we're there yet. So I think we should try to create something that says this is Bemi, but this looks fabulous. Veronica did an amazing job on this. I totally love this.
Yeah,
so let's see another look that we not so much like.
Okay, have you seen this one?
Oh.
And that was this one. Again, you know, it's the same kind of, it's this, the belt.
Mm.
And again, that's drawing attention to the waist, which isn't, it's not defined.
Mm.
It's the same problem. Also, there's the print. It's a bit too bright.
Mm.
And you know, she could look so much better.
Exactly. All right, so let's see another look that we like.
I love
this. Oh.
She looks stunning.
That is gorgeous. Her makeup and hair even look amazing as well. See, she works, Bemi works a lot with April Bikombi, who is a designer.
Okay.
And April Bikombi loves sequins. And I actually associate Bemi with sequins now because she does wear a lot of sequins.
Okay.
But this is a look that definitely is a Bemi look.
Yeah, sequins are not so safe.
Yeah.
So I guess maybe we're wrong to say that she's completely conservative.
But also there's the cut of this dress very, very, very much complements her figure.
Yeah.
And just like, it just all works.
Yeah.
All right, so let's see some of the celebrities that we can use to we can compare her style to, or how we can, direction we can channel her style.
Okay, well, I think it's pretty obvious that we would choose one of the Kardashians.
Very cliche, but everyone can relate to this.
Yeah, again, these are the three of them, well, two of them, Kim
and Khloe.
Khloe aren't skinny,
mm-hmm.
but they still manage to look very classy.
Sometimes I would say Kim is a hit or miss. Sometimes
yeah,
I hear.
I completely agree, but the time when she gets it right, I'm just like, oh my God, like I love it. So yeah, this is
a nice look.
Peplum.
You can't go wrong with peplum, especially when you're curvy.
Exactly.
And you have boobs, of course.
Exactly. It just works. So
okay.
I was thinking when I saw this, I thought, you know, why don't we try peplum?
Lovely.
So you can see peplum somewhere.
All right, and then another
works.
Look.
Ooh,
blazers
one.
With leather.
Yeah. So I thought this was very interesting, and you know, it's bold.
Mm-hmm.
It's still classy, and I think
it's still very trendy and fashionable.
Still very trendy, so yeah. I think yeah, it should look something similar to this. This is why I picked a piece that was quite similar to this.
Lovely.
That's one of
the pants. White. Lovely.
So if she could just do like this, she's just dressed completely in white. And it's just, you know, you're going to look and you're going to look back.
And be like, whoa.
Look away and be like, what is she wearing? And yeah, so I want that kind of silhouette and that shape and the color. I want that for women.
All right, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. We have just had this meeting with the lovely Tenio Lasiego, designer of Clan, and she's also a style consultant. Well, you know where to find her. Tell them your address.
Okay, guys, it's plot 292F at Jose Ariogun Street. And any landmarks, I can only say Staco Insurance. We're right next door.
In so, Victoria yeah, Island.
Victoria Island. See you soon.
All right, so now we're going to go back upstairs and see how she's getting her hair done, her makeup, and then we'll go down to wardrobe and we'll give you the final look. Don't get anywhere, we'll be right back.
Play my baby, then go say anything where they wanna say my baby. We go be anything that we wanna be. I'm in love with you, baby girl, I'm in love with you. Wanna dance with you, baby girl, wanna dance with you.
Hello, Sari. Oh, this is, oh, the makeup looks so nice. All right. So can we turn up the dryer for 1 second so I can just ask you what's going on? So what look, cause she's wearing a dress, what is she wearing?
She's wearing a tulip dress.
Okay.
Black.
Shimmer.
Yeah,
shimmer. Nice. So this makeup looks good on it. And what are we doing with the hair, sorry?
Well, as I told you, and you're gonna do our volume curls.
Okay.
With the bouncy, then you style the hair, then mix the hair glamour with the dress because the dress is really nice.
Mm-hmm. And then for the second look, what is she? Oh, sorry, I didn't ask makeup. Makeup, what are you doing for her dress?
I'm just trying to make it look
glamour. Okay. What colors are you working with?
I'm working with the blues colors because she has a
dark
skin.
Okay.
So I'm trying to give it with the blues colors and then with the brown colors.
Okay. Okay. So earth tone. All right, very nice. And for the second look? What color is it?
Black.
Okay. What are you going to do with her hair? Okay.
Classic look of pants and mm-hmm. sweet and like, we have a special hair up to for us.
Okay.
So it's on a spark our hair up.
Lovely. And what are you going to do for the black pantsuit, Miss Essay?
For the black pantsuit, I'm just going to touch up a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Give a little bit of smoky eyes.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Lovely. All right. So we'll leave you to do what you do best, and then we'll just stand in the corner and watch you do your job. All right.
They call me Ben.
It's Nyaya.
We know.
What can we canoe?
I suppose the man.
Sarah's signature's hat mad to you. All right, Tenny, tell her what she's wearing today.
Okay, we've picked out a peplum blazer and some white leg pants. So, yeah.
Thank you. All right, go ahead, girl, do it. Let's go stand in this corner, wait for you to get dressed.
So I'm standing now, we're waiting for that beautiful moment when Bemi is going to come out and reveal her outfit number one. Bemi, we're ready for you. Everyone that loves you is out here waiting for you right now. Oh my God! Wow! Look. Look at you. Oh, put your hand down. Why are you? Plan. Oh, you've done an amazing job. You like it? Don't you like this look? Very business, but stylish.
Business? I'm sure I'll get a lot of checks.
You will get some nice checks. Oh my God, you look amazing. What do you guys have to say?
I like the blazer a lot and the pants. It's really nice.
So on behalf of Clan and Reality Access, we're going to give you the blazer to go
with.
Thank you very
much.
Clan, are you happy about that? Sari, you want to give her the hair? And what do you guys have to say? I mean,
I've known her for a very long time. She looks different.
Oh my God. All right. So now we're down to the final look. And I can't say that I am not excited. Tenny, is it going to be a fabulous dress? Because I know you've seen it. It's going to knock me out? Are you sure about that? Can you put the money down on that? Oh, okay. I see you using all these words on me. Okay. Darling, Essay, is her makeup going to be fly? This is for Epiphany Makeovers, darling. I hope you're not doing me wrong. Fabulous? And Sari, what are you going to say about her hair?
What all the Sari signature does for you.
Okay. I say no more. And you're going to be happy to see her because you guys have known her for a very long time, right? All right, baby, let's see the second look. I'm ready. Oh my God. Oh wow. Okay, the prosthetic leg. I see you, Angelina Jolie. Oh, you look and you feel happy. Tell me how you feel in this dress. Really? Sari signature? Okay, Sari. And what did you have to say about Clan and this experience so far?
I mean, the dresses are very nice, they fit well. I tried on some other stuff earlier before this and everything, but I think this one was really nice.
Okay.
And I really like the blazer, and I'm taking it home.
Well, I'm really, 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 really happy that you like this. Well, I cannot apologize for kidnapping you. You have to go thank your people at Beat FM who planned this with me.
I have to say it was scary.
It was scary? Because you looked really, really confused, weren't we? But trust me, you look really fly. And hairstyles and makeup, I know you love. Baby darling, it was lovely to have you on the show.
Thank
you look
you.
Fabulous.
Thank you very much.
And I hope you like your blazer.
Yes, I do.
We'll be calling you to. I hope you don't do this. I hope you don't do this back to me because you know I do karate.
Oh really?
Yeah. If anyone tries to kidnap me, they'll be missing your teeth, your eyeballs. So. I'm serious.
Oh,
yeah, you can't do this back to me though. But thank you so much, guys. Thank you so much, everyone, for tuning in to the transformation episode on Reality Access. I am Tracy. Thank you so much, Sari, for joining us. You did an amazing job with her.
Thank you
so much, Clan. You are a very good sport. You tried. And Essay from Epiphany Makeovers. I want to thank you again. I want to say thank you to this great space that we used to do this entire shoot. Ocean Bay Mall. You're fantastic. You guys have to come here. Home Fabric Store in Ocean Bay Mall. This is what's the address? Help me out. 24 Deja Street.
Opposite Lagoon Hospital.
Guys, it was great. Thank you so much. See you next week on Reality Access. Mwah. Don't believe the hype. For more scoop about the show, make sure you log on to www.realityaccess.tv. And make sure you also follow us on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. I love you guys. Bye.
Every day, I wake up knowing that the more people I try to save, the more enemies I will make. And it's just a matter of time. before I face those with more power than I can overcome. I'm so sorry, I'm late. I had a traffic thing.
Did your traffic jam have anything to do with being, I don't know, shot at by machine guns?
Yeah, yeah. Oh, that was implied. I was implying that.
Peter Park.
Harry Osborn.
You're gonna want to see this.
Oscorp.
Get you
under surveillance.
Why?
Isn't that the question of the day?
There's something you're not telling me, Aunt May.
I once told you that secrets have a cost. The truth does, too.
My name is Richard Parker. I have discovered what Oscorp was going to use my research for. I have a responsibility to protect the world from what I know they're capable of.
What is all this?
The future.
We literally can change the world.
What about Peter?
Not everyone has a happy ending.
Bigger than you, Peter.
I made a choice.
This is my path.
Soon, everyone in the city will know how it feels to live in a world